we're about, what, 7150?
7150 now.
Is it 7150?
Yeah, they just changed, it used to be 7200.
Or do Canadians go down to 7050? But anyway, on 40 meters, if you want to work Canadians, you work in split, because they're all transmitting down where we can't go.
So what happens is they're transmitting down below, and you're transmitting up high, but you're listening down below. So you split your radio to transmit on one frequency and listen on another. Well, it works well, unless you happen to be parking your VFO on 14300 and not connecting the brain. You're listening on 14050 or whatever. It's probably a bad example on 20 meters, but the issue applies. You have people operating nets every day of the week, every weekend. They expect to still be able to use the ham bands, and they really get irate when contesters start crowding the bands. So it's forever an issue of courtesy, and it's an issue of legality.
Is there some customary splits for the different bands, or
different bands work different?
The splits generally, whatever the DX station can hear best on, where he has the less noise.
He will announce. Let's say that on 40 meters, he'll be on 7040. And he's calling CQ listening 7228.
Oh, he calls it.
Yep. They almost always, because there's, we outnumber, Americans outnumber the North Americans, outnumber them by many fold, typically. They announce their frequency, and so you call them on the frequency they claim to be listening on. And that way, hopefully, the rest of the people will have their knobs adjusted correctly so they're not transmitting and walking all over the sky. So everyone can hear him, and he has to pick you out of the crowd. It's a challenge.
I've heard they've used a range of frequencies, not just one. That makes it more difficult, too.
For DX, that's true. During a contest, it doesn't happen that often.
Okay.
There are so many people using such a narrow piece of spectrum, they don't have the luxury of listening to a band. During the expedition, though, that does happen. The same phenomenon happens.
There was a group out from Tunisia one time. They were transmitting at 14180, listening from 190 and up. And they were, and I followed them, because I followed them with my receivers and could tell where they were working, and they went all the way up to 20.
The net people will call us ghost operators, because they'll hear you calling him, but you're not listening on that frequency, mm-hmm. and so you're really creating QR mirroring, causing a problem. And that's the reason there's friction. There's too many people using a small spectrum without connecting the brain first. That is one of the things about HF. If you're accustomed to FM, there can only be one station using it at a time because of the nature of the mode. But sideband, in particular the CW, a lot of people can use the same spectrum. Anyway, why do we do this? First of all, one of the things about contesting that is unique is that by treaty, international treaty, we are prohibited from taking money to practice our craft. You can't do it for hire. And consequently, there are rules about, you know, prizes. The winner cannot get a new Mark V, or the winner can't get the newest ICOM, or the newest antenna setup, or whatever, because then they would be doing it for compensation. So why do we do it? Well, it's a good question. I don't know that I can necessarily answer it, but a lot of it has to do with chasing paper. You know, what other opportunity do you have to jump on an otherwise dead 10-meter band, especially during this part of the cycle? And during the day, 10 meters is actually wide open to huge parts of the world, if people were just there. And during a contest, they will be there. And you'll hear them, and you can work them. and taking advantage of those opportunities to collect cues can be a lot of fun. It's a great way to spend an afternoon.
Everyone's getting antsy for 10 meters.
That'll never hold.
I got lucky. I worked South Africa on 10, and I thought that was never possible. But it can happen.
During the
without an amplifier.
I forget which contest it is. I think it's the CQ Worldwide that you give, the DX gives you their power. I was working a string of JAs up high in the 10 meter band. The band was just packed. I mean, 28K all the way up to 29.5. I mean, it was just packed. And I was only running 100 watts, and I had a limited antenna at the time. So I went up high in the band, and these QRPers found me. And I ran a string of them. And some of those guys claimed they were sub 1 watt. And they were just faint as could be. It's a lot of fun working in Japan at 200 milliwatts. Wow. That's dramatic. But it's not uncommon at a watt or two. And that is one of the aspects of contesting that a lot of people gravitate to. Once you've worked every country on every band, now what am I going to do? Well, sometimes they get rid of that 300 watt radio and they go back to their little 2 watt rig or their tuna tin 2 and see what they can do with that.